At the end of the 90s, we had a massive wild radish problem, particularly in the northern wheat belt of Western Australia. Growers really thought that wild radish was going to be the downfall of cropping. We just couldn't control it. We had huge problems. A lot of growers have put their mind to it. They've used an integrated approach, and we got some new herbicides, and we're having a win. The latest ARI random survey for herbicide resistance done by Michelle Owen at ARI with GRDC Investment has some good and bad news. So obviously herbicide resistance levels are still very high. The good news is that when they sampled in 2010, they found 90 wild radish populations from the 500 fields that they visited. In 2015, they only found 65. We still have high levels of ALS resistance, cross resistance to the IMIs, 60-odd% resistance, so 60% of populations with resistance to 2,4-D, 65% of populations resistant to diflufenican, and that's probably the one that has moved a bit. Diflufenican resistance has gotten worse, and 17% with resistance to atrazine. So we still have this suite of herbicides where wild radish is resistant. We luckily have some new herbicides which are making a big dent in the problem. But the other thing that we are doing is that we've really run down that wild radish seed bank. Wild radish, like other weeds, the WeedSmart Big Six is a really good place to start to look at that diverse weed management. So WeedSmart, industry initiative, chemical companies are funding it, GRDC are investing in WeedSmart, and we've created the Big Six. So the Big Six is crop and pasture rotation, it's double knocks, it's mix and rotate herbicides, crop competition, stopping seed set, and harvest weed seed control. Post-emergent wild radish control, we were spraying radish that big and we were killing it for $5, and then we got resistance and it was no longer dying. Through some GRDC investment, through the RCSN in Geraldton, myself and Grant Thompson did some trials a few years ago, and the finding really found was that what we really need to do was spray radish that big. Spray radish the top of a beer can size, or a coffee cup if you like, spray small radish twice and mix and rotate. So can we use one or two herbicides early and then another two herbicides late in the same year and spray small wild radish? And we've seen a big shift to that in growers in Western Australia, and it really is paying dividends. Growers are having a big win with wild radish control. In terms of crop rotation, what we have now is some fantastic products in our cereals, particularly Velocity, the herbicide from Bayer. To date, we haven't found any resistance to Velocity, and growers know that they can pull it out of the shed and go and spray cereal with Velocity and kill the radish. But we are obviously wary of the fact that we could get resistance to that herbicide as well, so we don't want to be complacent. So where we were having trouble killing wild radish in wheat, we can reliably kill it now. We need to keep it that way and keep employing all of these other tactics, including things like harvest weed seed control after we've used Velocity to try and avoid evolving resistance to that precious herbicide. Of our weeds in Australia, wild radish is probably the one where harvest weed seed control is most effective. It retains a lot of its seed at harvest at a good height, so we can get the comb under it and pick up a lot of that seed. And we know that with the mills that's destroying the seed, we know that with all of the other practices we're using for harvest weed seed control, it's really effective on wild radish. If we've got a lot of radish in our crop every year and we're relying on that harvest weed seed control, we probably need to look at other parts of the system and maybe change our herbicides or change our crop competition, or make sure we use something to stop seed set as well as using the harvest weed seed control, so we're not completely reliant on it. Even though we feel like we're having a win with wild radish in Western Australia, with fewer populations found in the random survey, wild radish is still one of our top two or three weeds in Western Australia, and that will be the ongoing focus of RE research in the future.